Look, it's Brooke. As you guys know or don't know, I am a hairstylist and I work at a blow dry bar, which is pretty much I wash and blow dry their hair. I have some clients who think that they are better than everyone. This particular client was one of those. I would seriously call her a client from hell. We bonded right away. She was very, very sweet. She was kind of quiet on the quiet side, and I completely respect that because I'm kind of on the quiet side too. She was the mother of a bride coming in the next week, and she just wanted like a trial run for her hair too. So I was like, okay, great, you can come to me next week too. And she was so excited about it. We were talking when I was washing her hair. During the middle of it, she kind of just stopped talking to me. Okay, maybe she just wants to stop talking, so you know, I stopped talking. And we got done, and she had wanted just kind of some flips in her hair. She wasn't very particular is what she said. She just kind of wanted some flips, some movement, so that's what I gave her. I put the brushes down. I asked her, you know, how is everything. She turned psycho. Like, I swear to you, this lady just snapped. She looked at it and she said, I do not want this. And then she started reaching back to the back of her head and like scratching, like clawing herself in the back of her head, saying that it wasn't dry. I always feel it when I'm done. Her hair was dry. I kind of reached up to feel it again because I was like, okay, maybe it's not dry. Right as I was going to stick my hand up in there, she smacked my hand. And I'm not saying it was like a, okay, get off me. It was a smack, like, you better get your hand away from your girl. I was terrified. Like, I mean, I've never had a client try to hit me before. She literally smacked my hand away from her head when I was just trying to help. And I said to her, ma'am, I can curl it for you. I can straighten it for you. I can tease it for you. I can re-blow dry it. I can do anything. Let me help you. And she screamed at me. And let's back up a little bit. This is a Saturday, so the entire salon was full of people. I've never been more embarrassed in my life. And she proceeds to scream at me, saying that she does not want to talk to me anymore and that she wants the manager now. I'm a very sensitive person, so someone screaming at me saying anything makes me scared. And the fact that this lady wouldn't even like give me a chance to help her and just started going off at me. She stood up, she started yelling at me in my face. It was terrifying. I felt like I was being attacked by this lady who I didn't know. I went to the back and I, of course, got my manager, kind of told her what was happening. The lady was psycho to her too. She did not want to hear anything she had to say. So I stayed in the back while my manager went and talked to her. I heard from her after this was all done that she actually started crying. Not because her hair was bad, but because she felt bad that she got me in trouble. My manager's like, she's not in trouble. You just didn't like your hair. It looked fine. She just didn't like the way I did it, which is totally fine. And I respect that. The way she handled it was not appropriate. So my manager was like, okay, we can just give you another blowout because, like I said, we just do blowouts. It's not like I colored her hair green or cut off 6 inches that she didn't want cut off. I blow dried her hair. We could literally go back and wash it for you and you're fine. So she comes back in. Like 2 hours later, I'm still there. I'm working on another client. And in order to get to the wash house to wash her hair, you have to go by my station. So as she's coming by, she's literally has her hand up like this, like completely mortified that I'm still there. So she's like hovering and like walking like this, like trying to tiptoe by. And the stylist was like, you're fine. Like, it's fine. Just ignore her. Like, trying to like get her to stop. And she was just hunched over and like so awkwardly embarrassed. And I was like, well, I mean, you did it. I didn't do anything. You should be embarrassed. Honestly, if I just threw a tantrum and knew that it was a bad thing to do, I wouldn't go back to the salon, especially the same day. Like, this just happened and you want your hair done again? I think that she just didn't like me personally. She sat down in another stylist chair and the first thing she said was, I can already tell it's better. She didn't even do anything to you yet. She had to sit at the station next to me to get her hair done that time. Oh, so awkward. She was giving me the side eye. I was doing a client. Like, leave me alone. I'm trying to do my own client here. And she was just staring at me, and she would turn around in her chair and stare at me. And I was like, lady, I am not doing your hair. You don't have to worry about it. I will not look at you. I will not touch you. Just stop staring at me. I've had so many crazy clients. If you guys want another one of these, I can definitely do it for you. I think anyone who works in customer service kind of understands that. Just any customer can be psychotic. I didn't expect a grown woman to start screaming at me and smacking me. What am I supposed to do to that? It's not like I can smack her back. Got a lot of like stress off me somehow. I don't know. I'm like venting to you guys. Like, you guys are my best friends. Like, let me just like word vomit all over you. It's pretty much what I did. So I love it. Word vomiting for fun. Bye. Oh, that I'm hurting. This life's not easy. I'm not made out of steel.